Hello everyone. Welcome to Thoughts on Education with College Dunya. Today we have with us Dr. Aram Gannal, who is the chairperson of Gnanamani College of Technology. We're glad to have you here today, sir. It's great that you could take out time for us today.
Thank you, ma'am. Hello everyone. I am Aram Gannal, chairman of Gnanamani Education Institution in Namakkal, located in Nishalam Namakkal Highway itself. We have engineering college, we have B.Ed. college, we have integrated college of education and schools. In our campus, we have more than 4,000 student strength in our campus. We are running this in our institution successfully from 2004 onwards. I am very much happy to give an interview with College Dunya. I wish this team do the very best job in the current scenario. I wish all the very best. Thank you.
So, sir, like we know, you've been associated with a lot of institutes. And I'd like you to tell us more about what keeps you connected with the education sector.
Yes, ma'am. Our Gnanamani Education Institution was started in 2006. 2006, we started engineering college. From starting itself, we tie up with the ISTE, Indian Society for Technical Education, and we have tie up with CII, and we have tie up with all government and non-profit organization, the service organization, everything for the purpose of, apart from syllabus, we want to provide a real-time knowledge to our students. Through this association, we can able to provide the extra knowledge, extra real-time knowledge. Through them, we provide for our students. So this type of association is necessary for students' betterment, students' development. For that purpose, we have lot of association with another organization. Apart from that, we have lot of job opportunity programs we are conducting in our campus. The job opportunity program is nothing but the students are studying in their syllabus. For what purpose they are studying, they don't know at the time of examination, at the time of their completing the degree. After completing their degree only, they can be able to understand they studied in the purpose. Say, example, telecommunication. They have digital and signal processing. The subject is digital and signal processing. This is the basic core for all communication electronic students. But students just feel that it is one of the subject. But after they completing the degree, based on that digital and signal processing knowledge only, they are going to get a job in core area. So we realize that we are going to provide the real-time knowledge for our students at the time of they are doing the degree. For that purpose, we create a lot of tie-up with job opportunity program providers. Based on that, our students will be equipped for job. This is our past history, ma'am. Sorry, are you not?
Yes, sir. Sir, and as the chairman of this institute, what would you say your role is towards students and towards the faculty members?
As a chairman, is here, create. I am not a chairman. I am only a facility provider. Whenever they call as a chairman, I am not a chairman. I am a provider. Provider means a facility provider for our students' knowledge. We are creating a platform to gain the knowledge through our platform. For that platform means we have to create two things. One is developing the infrastructure, and second one is our staff strength. We have to appoint and select a proper staffs. As my point of view, I have to maintain a good staff strength, not only the staff and also the students. In 2 points, we are giving the regular motivation. One is our staff members has to motivated by themselves and providing the motivation from another agencies, and then we have to make them realization about the students' background, scenario, their current knowledge status, everything. We have to educate our staff members. Then only the staff members can able to provide a better result, better sharing the knowledge. And another point of view, for what purpose they come to the institution? In the institution, how they acquire their knowledge, in what way they can able to develop themselves, this type of motivations we are continuously giving. For example, in first year, we are providing a communication skill for students. In second year, we are providing technical skills. In third year, we are providing soft skills. These three skills are not in any syllabus. But at the same time, these skill sets has to developed by our faculty members, in-house our department, the training department, and also the faculty members, all of them jointly put together, they make the students to become as employable. It is not a product. If one side, if you put a raw material in next side, we can get the finished goods. It is a production unit, but it is not a production unit. It is a human development progress. Human development progress means we have to maintain very quality. We have to approach our students as a friendly approach. We have to advise. We have to create them to think. First progress is we have to make them to think. Second progress is we have to make them to create. Third progress only we can expect a result from our students. So this is our motivational process. Based on this motivational process, we developing our institution. Our students, lot of students are spread over in the world. Our alumni are lot of, around 70 countries. They are working in all over the world. This is our making a good institution, providing the better education to needy and poor peoples. In 2006, in Tamil Nadu, the engineering college numbers are very less. At the time itself, we decide we are going to create lot of engineers from poor background. At the same time, we have to provide better education, a world-class education. At the time itself, we decide 10% of our total intake, we are providing free seat for our in and around students. Our main aim is, in future, the new generation going to develop, they upgrade their lifestyle by way of knowledge, by way of their wisdom only. So we are the part of in that. We have to be part of in that. This is our vision in 2006, while we start the institution. But the vision and mission are changed due to the, based on the current situations. Nowadays, now what we plan, we have to make the younger generation to become as employable one. They have to become as a best human being of this world. This is our vision of our institution.
Right, sir. Sir, I want to know more about how the institute dealt with the pandemic. So, you know, everything practically went online overnight. And how were the faculty trained, and how did, you know, everything shift, the entire teaching mode shift online, and how was this taken by the students?
In our Jnanamani campus, from starting itself, we are making a digital resource center. That means in our campus, tomorrow our faculty, what class they are going to take, that title and their notes will be uploaded in our GRC center. That means Jnanamani Resources Center. In that center, the student can, you know, enroll it and they can able to view about the tomorrow lecture. We have soft material in from starting itself. Based on that soft material, in this pandemic situation, we can able to make it is convert as a online very easily. And moreover, we have tie up with some other institutions, like they through the online, they provide the education via VR and AR models. So in our institution, this is not a problem. We can able to manage. At the same time, the students also enjoying this online education. Where once they enter in our campus, they discuss and their practical session only they can come and do at their convenient time.
Okay, sir. So that is commendable, I think.
Yes.
Tell me more about what you think are the strengths of Jnanamani institutes. What it is that, you know, stands out?
We are going to create a model institution. This is our aim. For that, we believe and we have a strength of our first strength is our faculty members. Our second strength is the parents. They have the confidence about our institution. And third strength is our students. These are our strength to focus our aim and achieve our aim.
Okay, sir. Sir, lastly, I would want to, you know, ask you if you have any piece of advice for aspiring students who right now must be at this crucial stage of making career choices and deciding colleges, etc.
Pardon, madam?
Sir, I'm saying that what advice would you want to give students right now? So students right now are, you know, making career decisions and they're choosing colleges. And at this stage, what would your advice be?
I am telling this advice, it is not advice, it is my point of view. Each and every student has to understand their interest, area of interest. Based on that area of interest, they have to choose the course or career. The career is nothing but you are going to live in the career minimum 40 to 60 years. So you are going to live in the 40 to 60 years in your career means you have to equip yourself minimum 4 to 5 years. My best advice is the students don't study for examination purpose. Don't study for getting a degree purpose. Getting a degree or for studying the for purpose of examination is not help to your lifetime. You have to study your education, you have to learn your education, you have to create new things. My current scenario is the students are entering in the campus, they are completing the degree. With the degree they are going for the job is as usual. But my point of view, my aim is every student has to study in their interested area. In that, they have to create any product or service to the society. That means knowledge has to be transformed as a product or service. This is my advice. So please, our student community, you choose your wish. In your wish, you have to provide 100% commitment, 100% enjoyment, 100% involvement. If you provide these three things, surely you will be success, you will be pioneer of your faith. Getting a job is your aim. maybe it's a primary object, but I don't know, your main object is you are going to make a world, new world. You have to create a thing. You have to become as a service or product wise, you have to create a things. For that purpose, you have to search a problem. Wherever the problem, you can able to find a solution. If you find a solution, that is become as a product or service. This is the knowledge. For that purpose only you are going to study. For that purpose only you are going to survive. If you fulfill this purpose, surely our community will be enjoy a lot.
Very rightly said, sir. I am sure students will find this very insightful. Thank you for giving your time and this interview with us.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Thank you a lot.